The victory celebrations may have been loud and long, but the period after the Second World War proved to be a time of austerity and rationing, particularly in Britain. Yet, as the 1940s drew to an end, it was becoming possible for the first time in a long while to travel abroad safely once again, if someone could only provide the opportunity. The year is 1949, and a 40-year-old Englishman has just opened for business in a small fourth-floor office in London's Haymarket. The name of this enterprising Englishman is Walter Bridge, and the name of the company, Bridge.
My ambition when I first started in business was to create a kind of miniature Thomas Cooks, if you like. In other words, creating holidays around Europe which would give the people the feeling that they were being very personally looked after.
The first Bridge holidays offered a variety of packages to a number of different countries. But after trying to be all things to all men, Walter came to a critical decision.
One very good idea would be to specialise. Specialise in something, a country that you knew well, which I knew well. And I came out in favour of Switzerland. It's not the cheapest of countries, but it has pretty well everything. The scenery, the food, the mountains, the lakes, the people, and the climate. And so I found that that had the makings of very attractive holidays and not too dear.
This innovative approach worked. Walter's new Swiss travel service was soon doing brisk business. This philosophy has remained at the heart of the company's approach to travel ever since and is the basis of its enduring success. Pausing only to marry Alma, his lifelong companion and business partner, Walter continued to expand his operations. And when Alma came up with the idea of offering the same kind of specialist service to Paris, the company was soon operating Paris Travel Service as well, with Alma in charge. The Belgian Travel Service followed soon after that. From a tiny one-man operation, Bridge had grown in just a few short years to include three specialist companies, now located around Ebury Street, all with their separate staffs and experts. And then along came the 60s. Suddenly, Western economies were booming. We'd never had it so good. This is the era that saw the rise of cheap charter air holidays to the coasts of the Mediterranean, and especially to Spain's Costa del Sol. Bridge Travel was one of the very first to offer holidays by air, but it was intent on taking a very different direction from these low-value charter packages. It was in these years that its core principles of scheduled flights, quality hotels, and harmonious relations with agents were firmly established as the differentiators for a Bridge holiday. 1964 needs a special mention. This is the year Alma Bridge engaged the services of a young man who will later play a leading role in our story. Richard Dupuis, Bridge's current group director.
It was a relatively small business when I first started. I actually started with Paris Travel Service, one of the group. We were carrying about 5,000 passengers at the time, and we were in offices in Victoria, London, South West 1.
As the 60s came to an end, Bridge Travel added what was to become one of its most successful offerings to the fold, the London Travel Service.
Walter Bridge had, of course, created a very unique concept of specialist destination holiday companies, and I very quickly tuned into that wavelength, and we expanded on the concept.
By this time, Bridge Travel was collectively carrying over 50,000 clients a year, but that was only just the start. During the 70s, the company moved to new premises in Ware. Swiss Travel extended into the ski holiday business, and the group doubled the annual number of its clients, achieving an annual turnover of £6.5 million.
Coming to 1978, I was beginning to think of retiring, and in order to do so, I needed to sell the business to somebody. Now, I was very well acquainted with a charming man in Belgium with whom we had worked together for a long time. This was Mr. Rudolf van Moerkerke. He believed similarly to us in specialization and very personal, very painstaking service to the clients. And he was, to my delight, he decided to carry on the tradition of Bridge Group without much alteration.
In 1979, when Walter and Alma Bridge finally retired forever from the company, the turnover from Bridge Travel's various businesses exceeded £10 million. On the very first day of 1979, Richard Dupuy had been appointed Group Managing Director, the role he still holds today. During the 80s, Richard oversaw the continued growth of the group, radically expanding its short break programmes.
In due course, of course, we added more specialist companies, namely to London and Amsterdam, and as late as 1992, of course, our major operation to Disneyland Paris.
In 1992, Paris Travel began operating its specialist arm, Disneyland Paris, which has consistently carried more families to this top attraction than any other operator. More flexible, imaginative, and attractive packages have followed throughout the decade, including partnerships with P&O Ferries for self-drive holidays and the immensely successful City Break program, which has leveraged the expertise of all the specialist companies within the group. Bridge Travel has also used the opening of the Channel Tunnel to become the recognised leader for train-based holidays to Europe, winning Eurostar's Top Tour Operator Award every year since. Now under the new ownership of a British company, Air Tours PLC, and working from its new purpose-built offices at Broxbourne in Hertfordshire, Bridge Travel carries well over 350,000 people every year, with a turnover of over £85 million. And is ready to take on the challenges that lie ahead in the next century. With its commitment to innovation, imaginative packages and quality standards, a passion for excellence, an unrivaled reputation, and above all its specialist approach, Bridge is poised to develop new markets for the future and widen its offering still further. So that one thing at least is certain, Bridge is going to remain the name for great holidays for a long time to come.